Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you guys? How is everything going? In the previous video, we were able to visualize the data or the brew file data that come out of the brew file mode in Xdebug using the PHP Storm visualization tool. This time, we want to explore a slightly more advanced GUI. You can use it to make the same modification in the visualization, but in more advanced way. So, what is that? If you go, for example, to the Xdebug documentation, you will find what you can use for analyzing the profiler. There is a program named QCacheGrind. If you go to it, you will see what QCacheGrind is. It's a visualization tool that helps you visualize the data that comes out of the profile. Okay? And QCacheGrind is available and you can install it on Linux. And there is an alternative named QCacheGrind available for Windows and for Mac. At the same time, you will find installation guides for all operating systems in the video description below. Okay, let's first install QCacheGrind, which is alternative to QCacheGrind for macOS, and start to see how it will work with us. Okay, after we go, for example, to the terminal and type pro install QCacheGrind. It will begin installing QCacheGrind from scratch, and at the same time, let's see if it will work for us or not. Okay, then clear. After that, we tell it to run QCacheGrind. It will open this program with a beautiful UI. Here we can load which file. It will load the caches that were there before. Okay, which is the output that come from the brew file mode, for example. Okay, then we can tell the program that we want to load this file. You will find here in the columns, the first thing is inclusive time, which represents the time taken by this file named index.php, a function named main, the time it took in total with the calls it made. For example, your index.php is the entry point of your PHP application or your Symfony application. So here inclusive time is the total time taken. And at the same time, the self time is the time taken by the code inside the index.php, regardless of the calls it makes. Because this is an important point, let's give an example. Imagine you have a file named index.php that calls another file named home.php. The inclusive time for index.php is, for example, 6 seconds. Out of those 6 seconds, 2 seconds are for the code of index.php, and 4 seconds are for the code after index.php made a call to home.php. The self time for home.php will be added to the inclusive time for index.php. So the total time or sum of them is the inclusive time. So we can differentiate it between inclusive time, which represents the time for the code in the file itself, in addition to any calls to the other files, and self time, which means the time for the code in the file itself without any external calls. Okay, then you find here the number of calls, which is how many times this function was called. For example, you have a function named event dispatcher dispatch. The number of calls for this function is 15 times. Why? Actually, when we saw, for example, in our Symfony course and talked in details about the Symfony core, and said that it's based on event and event driven. Then the event dispatcher function, dispatch function itself, was called 15 times, whether we are doing a request or a response or a terminate from the HTTP kernel from Symfony, for example. Okay, then there's a function itself, the basic function that does the execute and its allocation. Here you can see the source code when you select it. And at the same time, the most important or the beautiful visualization in QCacheGrind at the call graph. And call graph presents all the output but as a graph. For example, if we go to the main and scroll all the way down and see, scroll all the way down, yes. And if we came here and said, okay, scrolled up, you will see your entire call graph. You will find all your call stack in details. From the moment you went to the main from the first index.php until the last thing, which is terminate and response. For example, and the response returned and the terminate was made from the HTTP kernel. And at the same time, it displayed the inclusive time. Okay, for instance here, you have the index.php, which make a call to autoload.php. This is in turn reference to the files in the vendor directory using Composer. then it starts the cycle of Symfony kernel, the HTTP kernel runner. This runner has two calls. One goes to terminate and the other one calls to handle. If you notice a sticker arrow, it signifies that this particular branch takes longer. For example, terminate concludes first, only after sending the response. And meanwhile, handle has a sticker arrow, amplifying it takes more significant amount of time. That's why one process takes up 80% and the other takes up 14%. Okay? Descending further, you will see handle has two calls. The first takes up about 69% and the second roughly 11%. The call that consumes a longer time has a sticker arrow. Okay, and then you can keep following the visualizer presentation until you pinpoint the most time-consuming segment in your code. Okay, for example, if we go to the index, I have it, it's code. Okay, clicking on it allow me to delve deeper. Okay, relieving the code, the actual code under this, you will find that source code. If I navigate to call or the call map, it provides a comprehensive overview all the calls, like the documenter, for example, from Symfony component, can be visualized. The main point here is that tool like QCacheGrind or KCacheGrind are very useful and can be employed for visualization. However, if this is the only tool or not, okay, actually, no, you can also utilize Blackfire. Okay, what is Blackfire? Before going back into visualization, let's discuss Blackfire. And the Blackfire allows you to monitor, profile, and test your application before deploying it into production. It aids into identifying performance issues, time constraints, and the potential problems in your code. Blackfire supports PHP, Python, and Go, and soon it will extend support to Ruby and JavaScript. While you can use Blackfire with Symfony, it's also compatible with Laravel. However, Blackfire is a paid service. You will need to check their pricing and determine which package suits your needs. But remember, it's not free. On the other hand, you can use QCacheGrind for free to visualize the output from Xdebug profile mode. Okay, let's returning to the QCacheGrind. You will note that all the calls made in your file, each function's time, consumption, and related calls are displayed. For instance, the event dispatcher calls two files. One took up 33% of the time, and the other took up 15%, okay, and so on. By following this, you eventually reach the last file, factory create for namespace. Actually, I'm not familiar with its function, but there is also the PHP documenter reflection, which portion to Symfony and the vendor, but actually it's not our primary concern. The main takeaway is observing the time consumption. For example, in the app controller and index took up 55% of the time, it calls two other files, create form, which consumed 3%, it's not a big deal, and handle requests, which also consumed a little time. Okay, let's apply the same concept here. We will create a function, and this function will take a long time. Then let's look at its visualization. How will it be displayed? Okay, let's come over here to our code. Now we can close this. We don't need it anymore. And then, for example, in the login service, it's the same thing exactly. Okay, let's go here, for example, and use for each, okay, or a for loop. Just for, okay, for example, if you came here and return, no, I don't want to anything now. Okay, here, for instance, I will define a new array. The array is called data equals array. Okay, then if I came over here, for example, more than anything, I can say here, for example, data equals I. What do I want to do here? Actually, I want to create a for loop that consumes memory. So that we can see if you can visualize the time, and at the same time, you can visualize the memory. Okay, here, for instance, I made a for loop. It continues for about 10,000 time or roughly 100,000 time. And those 100,000 repetition will add a new element inside the data array. After that, we can see how it visualizes. Okay, let's come here, for example, and in the profile, we will delete all of these files. And this is, we can start over clearly. Okay, we will delete them and move them to the bin. Okay, And then we will go over everything one more time. Xdebug works in PHP in profile mode. Okay, everything is ready now. Okay, let's check the server. Okay, next, I can start the server. Okay, is our server running or not? I can't remember. If we go here, for example, and say, okay, the server is running. Okay, let's go here. I tell it I want to log in. Okay, log in. Then I can say test, then login. All right, I went straight there. And like that, had the for loop finished or what? Where did we come, for instance, the login service? It should have finished here. Why it's so fast? Okay, let's see if the profile has shown anything to us or not. The login appeared here. Okay, let's see the login again. For example, in the visualization program, here I can load something else, which will be the login. Okay, when it comes to the main, let's go there. You can see the time here. You can see the data here. And here you can see exit like this. Find where the index is. Where is the index? Okay, handle request. Blah blah blah. Where the login? Okay, we can search for the login service. The login service didn't take any time. It didn't take any time. Okay, get to the login service. Okay, where is the login service? Let's see the function itself. The login itself didn't take any time at all. If we came here to the login, we see here what? Okay, handle row, app, index, it took about 2%. And this is strange. So basically this function didn't work at all, I think. Okay, let's go back again. Check the data, return username and password for la 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 la. 100,000 times. Okay, let's for example change it to a very large number, for example, to see what will happen. Will it work or not? Okay, if we go if we came to the app controller and we log in again, so we'll go to the login function, then it to the for, then inside the for we find okay plus plus, everything seems fine. Okay, let's see. Maybe the processor is that fast. Okay, that's great. If you came to the app controller, I went to the login, and here we delete all of these files. So we don't want to have anything old. We will use it freshly, and from the login, test, then login. It has a size error. Exactly. This is what I expecting. Okay, because I thought the size itself might be a problem. Okay, let's remove those, and if I came here and can use PHP max, then I can modify to use PHP int max. So now it's the maximum possible int value that can set in PHP. Okay, if I came here and refresh again, and then test, then another test, then login, it tells you there is a memory issue. Okay, memory issue. Do you see, guys? It turns out the memory issue. Now we have a memory issue. So let's look what happens in the profiler. And this is a good chance for us to look at the memory visualization. Okay, if you check the QCacheGrind now and go here, for example, and check the last file, which is the login file. What is this? It's probably the output. Okay, let's come and see this. Okay, let's see this time. But instead of just the time, we can also display the memory. Okay, where is the secondary event type? Okay, select memory. If you came here and look at the login service, come and see the function named login. Okay, did you see how much is consumed? It consumes about 27. At the same time, if you check the time here, you will find that the memory is about 70%. All the other files probably consumed any memory. The login service alone took up to 70% of the memory. Okay, let's scroll down a bit and look at the graph visualization. If we tell it in the login service, here you have the kernel taking up 75%. if we scroll down and comparing to before, there's almost nothing. Only the login service took up 74.93% of the memory. From this, you can pinpoint exactly where the problem is. If you check the memory per bit and choose the time, you will find that the login service consumes 55% of the time. If you go up, you will see that almost all the code it took negligible time, only 28%, compared to the login, which took up to 55% of the time. Okay, and of course, this will increase the consumed time in the inclusive time for everything before it, as we explained before. Okay, so the idea is that we can visualize the memory and at the same time visualize the time. Okay, if we came here after checking the for loop and its impact on memory, we can remove it and replace it to or with a sleep. Okay, here we can set 10 seconds. Okay, let's see what happened. I also delete all the files, move them to the pen. Okay, then try to log in again. Okay, test, then log in. Okay, we will have to wait for 10 seconds. Let's see how these 10 seconds will be displayed in the QCacheGrind. Okay, let's go to the QCacheGrind and load the new file. The new file is login. Then I searched for the login service and look at the function, then the login. You will find that now the time is approximately 97 or 98% of the time being consumed by the login function. Okay, it's an inclusive time. Why? For example, if we went here to this very function, you will find here in the graph exactly, you will see the handler row or the handle request. Then you go to the index from the app controller. Then you proceed to the login service. Okay, after all of that, did you see, guys? All of this consumed 97.73% of all the time in the sleep function. Therefore, 10 seconds was consumed in this function. Now imagine this function doesn't execute sleep at all for sure. It makes a call, for instance, to an external service. And this external service is not present. And you, for instance, haven't set a timeout. At this point, you have a problem. You haven't set a timeout and you will have a performance issue. In this way, you were able to identify which function is taking a lot of time. And at the same time, pinpoint the amount of time it consumes from the overall call or time of your execution request, or simply the time taken for your request execution. Okay, so guys, we understood how you can visualize using Xdebug, whether it's through using PHP Storm with visualization or use QCacheGrind or QCacheGrind if you are using Mac or Windows. In the next video, inshallah, we will start talking about code coverage. What does code coverage mean? It means that you can use Xdebug in a way that allows you to calculate the percentage of the code that has been covered by your tests. And this is what we will cover, inshallah, in the next video. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions, queries, or comments, I'm available on any social media. Thank you and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.